As college students head back to campus, coronavirus outbreaks at universities in at least 19 states, leading to concerns about scenes like this. A large gathering of students at Penn State that prompted the school's president to ask those flouting the rules, do you want to be the person responsible for sending everyone home? Mississippi's governor urging college students to be careful, since 18 to 29-year-olds make up the highest proportion of cases there.
We know that we've got a lot of work to do there. It's something that we will have to be constantly working on over the course of the next few months.
And with U.S. deaths from COVID-19 averaging more than 1,000 a day for 25 consecutive days, the CDC is now projecting nearly 195,000 COVID deaths by September 12th, about 3 weeks away, suggesting that staggering death rate will continue, at least in the short term.
We are beginning, I think, to turn the tide.
Still, CDC Director Dr. Robert Redfield, who estimates as many as 60 million people nationwide may have already contracted the virus, based on an infection rate of 10 to 20%, says we could soon see the number of new daily deaths begin to decline as more people follow public health guidelines like mask wearing, hand washing, and social distancing.
Hopefully this week and next week, you're going to start seeing the death rate really start to drop again.
New cases are steady or falling in 40 states. But Redfield warned that positive trend isn't taking hold everywhere.
We don't need to have a third wave in the heartland.
Coronavirus cases are on the rise in states like Wyoming, Iowa, and Illinois, with a new Emory University study suggesting so-called super spreader events are driving transmission in rural areas. Meanwhile, on the vaccine front,
no country can just ride this out until we have a vaccine.
A new sobering reminder from the head of the World Health Organization. The 1918 pandemic lasted 2 years. He hopes this one won't.
And even if we do have a vaccine, it wouldn't end the pandemic on its own.
Pfizer says the vaccine it is developing with German firm BioNTech is on track to seek regulatory review as early as October. And Johnson & Johnson plans to include up to 60,000 people in phase 3 trials for its vaccine.
Progress does not mean victory.